गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू पीजे अपडेट सेशन टू स्किल डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन। आई विल बी टेकिंग स्किल डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन ऑन हाउ टू यूज अ मैनुअल केरेटोमीटर। सो व्हाट डज केरेटोमेट्री मींस? केरेटो मींस कॉर्निया, मेट्री मींस मेजरमेंट। इट इज अ मेजरमेंट ऑफ द एंटीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ द कॉर्निया अक्रॉस अ फिक्स क्वाड लेंथ, यूजली 2 to 3 mm, विच लाइज विद इन द ऑप्टिकल स्फेरिकल जोन ऑफ द कॉर्निया। इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द अजम्पशन दैट द एंटीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ द कॉर्निया एक्ट्स एज अ परफेक्ट स्फेरिकल कॉन्वेक्स मिरर and the size of the image varies with the curvature of the cornea. So in 1796, Ramsden was the first one to introduce keratometer, followed by Helmholtz, Jawel and Schiotz, who modified the instrument for clinical use in around 1881. Let's come to types of keratometers. We broadly classify into two categories, manual and automated. In manual, we have Bosch and Lomb, which is the most commonly used, Jawel Schiotz keratometer and Zeiss ophthalmometer. In automated, we have the Topcon automatic keratometer, IOL Master by Zeiss, Pentacam, Opscan, Corneal Topography and the Humphrey autokeratometer, all of which gives us the keratometric values. So the types of optical system incorporated in keratometer in the Bosch and Lomb keratometer is one position keratometer, that is double images are produced side by side as well as at 90 degree up from each other. The principal meridians assumed to be at right angle to each other. It has a fixed object size with variable image size and variable doubling. Whereas this is exactly the opposite in the Jawel Schiotz type of keratometer, which is a two position where it requires rotation about the axis to measure each of the principal meridians. When the lamp illuminates the mirror by means of a diagonally placed mirror, light from the mirror strikes the patient's cornea forming the object. The objective lens focuses the light from the image along the central axis. There is a 4-aperture diaphragm present near the objective lens, and beyond the diaphragm there are 2 doubling prisms. Light passing through the left and the right aperture along the left and the right part of the central axis are deviated by means of base up and base down prisms. The light passing through the upper and lower aperture passes along the central axis. The total area of upper and lower apertures is equal to the area of each of the other 2 apertures. Thus, the brightness of the images is equal. So, the doubling principle is unique in Bosch and Lomb keratometer because during minimal involuntary movements during fixation of eye, the image formed by the anterior curvature of eye also moves with those minimal movements of the eye. Now, we come to demonstration of how to use a manual keratometer. So, these are the parts of a manual keratometer. As we can see, the eyepiece which is used for focusing. Then we come to the chin height knob and the headrest knob and the chin rest and the headrest where the patient aligns himself. Then we come to the keratometer height knob right at the bottom to adjust the mirrors over the patient's cornea. Then the focusing knob to exactly align the mirrors. And thereafter the horizontal and the vertical knob to align the axis in both the meridians, along with the anterior posterior rotation axis scale for oblique astigmatism or irregular astigmatism. Before we use a keratometer on any patient, it is important that we calibrate the keratometer machine by mounting a 5x8 inch steel ball bearing at position close to that normally of patient's eye. As we can see, we align the 3 mirrors as shown in the picture. After aligning the mirrors, you check for the vertical and the horizontal drum, which is around 45 in this case, which comes up to 0. Steel ball has a known radius of curvature, which upon proper calibration of keratometer can be correctly read. Focus the eyepiece of the keratometer for examiner's eye. Set the adjustable eyepiece as far counterclockwise as possible. Turn the eyepiece clockwise until the reticle or the plus sign is first seen as sharp focus. Adjust height of patient's chair and instrument to a comfortable position for both patient and examiner. Instruct patient to place chin on chin rest and forehead against forehead rest and adjust for patient. Raise or lower chin rest until patient's outer canthus or lateral canthus is aligned with mark on upright support of instrument. Now from outside instrument, roughly align the barrel with patient's eye by raising or lowering the instrument and by moving it to left or right until a reflection of mirror is seen on patient's cornea. One more easier way for the beginners is to shine torch light through the eyepiece and see the light reflecting on the patient, thereby adjusting the height knob and seeing the light falling onto the cornea. Look into the keratometer and refine the alignment of the image of Myers, that is three circle, on patient's cornea. During this time, instruct the patient to keep their eyes wide open and occlude the other eye with the occluder and tell the patient to blink normally. During focusing, the most crucial step is to focus the Myers and adjust the instrument so that the plus sign is centered on the lower right hand circle. After centration of the plus sign in the lower right hand circle, adjust the horizontal power wheel until the horizontal Myers are in close opposition. Once the horizontal Myers are in close opposition, adjust the vertical drum until the vertical Myers are in close opposition, thereby getting superimposition of plus plus and minus minus sign, making all three Myers aligned to each other. After the Myers are aligned, each of vertical horizontal drum Myers yields a meridional reading in diopters. So what with the rule astigmatism? That is, the vertical meridian dioptric power is more than the horizontal at 90 degrees. What's against the rule of astigmatism is when the horizontal dioptric power is more than the vertical at 180 degrees. So now in the third scenario, when the two plus signs are not aligned, we have to rotate the entire optical instrument till the two plus signs are aligned. The anterior posterior axis scales ranges from 0 to 180 degrees. After rotating the drum, when the tips of plus signs are aligned in the same plane, the scale associated with it indicates in degree 1 meridian of oblique astigmatism. Then the corneal radius of power is measured in this meridian and in the meridian 90 degree apart. What are the advantages or uses of manual keratometer? One of the most common use is for IOL power calculation for cataract surgery. In contact lens, to determine the base curves of lens, that is RGP or soft hydrogel lenses, to detect any abnormalities over the contact lens. To see follow-up of long-term usage of contact lens to check for any change in radius of curvature. To measure the pre- and post-surgical astigmatism post-graft or post-cataract surgery. To detect tear film abnormalities by means of distorting Myers. In such cases, we put a drop of lubricating and again recheck the keratometric values. It also gives us a rough estimate of refractive error in cases of hazy media or in any uncooperative patient. For detection of irregular astigmatism in cases like pterygium, corneal opacity or scarring, and in ectatic disorders like keratoconus, but it does not give values in advanced cases of any ectatic disorders. So what are the pitfalls of keratometer? Improper calibration of the instrument, faulty positioning of the patient, lack of proper fixation by the patient, localized corneal distortions or opacities or severe dry eye, improper eyepiece focusing and misalignment of Myers. So one of the most favorite Viva question asked by examiners is, what is the range of dioptric power present on the manual keratometer, that is the Bausch & Lomb? How do you calculate the K readings if it exceeds the range available on the keratometer? So to conclude, MK is the most widely used keratometer because of its low cost and ease of use. Despite latest advances in optical biometers for keratometry readings, still used as a second instrument for confirmation of K readings. Despite certain limitations, MK still remains part of the armamentarium in the pre-op workup setting for various corneal and cataract surgery. Thank you for your kind attention.